Yeah.
I put the smoke in my lungs till I can't breathe.
Till I can't breathe.
They don't know me.
They don't know me.
Nah. They don't know me.
They don't know me.
I put the smoke in my lungs till I can't breathe. I put one in the air for them niggas that claim that they hate me. They don't know me, nah, they don't know me. I put the smoke in my lungs till I can't breathe. I put one in the air for them niggas that claim that they hate me.
They don't know me,
nah, they don't know me.
Shoe Locker Wear Test and Reviews, and as you know, I'm your boy Young D Marks, and you know the slogan, we always on the hunt for something dope, comfortable, and something to get us through the course of each week or each day that we go through. So today on the podcast we have these. Now I know these are a little older as far as date wise, but I started kind of switching up my formula a little bit. As y'all know, I used to put the shoe out right when it came out, then I'd come back later and put a wear test in it. But that's why I changed the title to Wear Test and Reviews. So I already got my wear out of the shoe, kind of a little bit, somewhat, maybe. Not really, but I definitely wore the shoe. I definitely wore the sneaker. I definitely got the spin around. Now, as y'all know, it's just nothing but a typical Jordan 1 box. It's just a different color. But I like the color. I like that silver metallic kind of like off-white box. It gives it kind of like that good feel. So when you're going through your Jordans, you know exactly which one this is without even having to open the box. But enough with the small talk. Let's get to the shoes. Bang, bang. Get that box. I don't know how to get that out of there. All right. So we got the navy and white and silver Retro One High. And it's kind of formed like a mid, as y'all can see. The tongue is made like a mid top. It got that Nike Air on there. And then on the inside, it got the Jordan, like, on the mid. It don't have the individual shoe lock lace where you could go in between. You know what I'm saying? It only go across. As y'all can see, this is the only one of Jordan 1s that I have that is not union laced, because it's impossible to union lace them. Or I ain't gonna say it's impossible, but the way that I had to do it, it didn't look good to me, so I just left them as is. So this is the one. So let's talk about the pros. What I do like about it is it's a great shoe just to throw on with anything. I'm not a big blue fan, but as you see, I definitely had to get these because I like it. Like I said, they go with pretty much anything. This that shoe that you can throw on a good spring day, as long as it's not raining or anything, because it's going to go with pretty much anything. That's navy, silver, and white. You can't really beat too much of that. That's a Yankees hat. We got the original D hat. You know what I'm saying? You can get your flow on with these a little bit. Like I said, the only con that I really have is that they navy. I'm more of a red fan. For anybody that really do know me, y'all know I love red. So let's talk about the shoe and the materials. All right, so let's start with this one. I like the one thing I do like about it is the softer leather. It's kind of made like my crimson Jordan 1s. It's got that soft leather on it, so it makes it better as far as the bends. As you can see, it's not as creased up as it looks. Even though it looks creased up, it don't look, you know what I'm saying? It's still kind of got like that fine crease across it. Soft leather, make it real, you know, standout-ish. The suede on there, I think, is a big con. I'm not going to say a big con. It's a small con to me because, like I said, if it rains and you out in them, it's going to mess up your suede. But if you know how to take care of your shoes, you'll hit them with the 1, 2, 3, you feel me, 4, 5, 6, and you won't have to worry about it. This is a great shoe, just like I said, to wear anywhere else and out, you know, where you're going. It usually fits everything. It is a classic Jordan 1. It's mixed with the mid-top, so I'm going to say I only like it because it's a high top. If this was a mid, I would not like this shoe. But since it's a high, it can fit in my closet. It can go in my collection. I think out of all my Jordan 1s, I would rate this one maybe a 6 out of 10. Where I think all my other Jordan 1s are 7s, 8s, and 9s. Especially like my UNC to Chicago pack. That whole situation is a 10, you ask me. My Crimson's a 9.5. Just because it had pink in it, it kind of really threw me off. But let's get to the view. Like I said, I like the materials on the mate. And then as y'all can see, I wear my shoes, so y'all see the bottom is definitely wore. The soft leather made on there, that suede. And then, you know, you can talk about the material on the Nike sign. It's shaky off the silver Nike sign. It kind of looked a little cheesy. I do like that bubble-ish Michael Jordan logo, the Air Wings logo right here on the side. It's kind of like a bubble. It's not like made like that typical Jordan 1. And that's just like plastered on the side. I think that's a great touch. They should put them on a lot of Jordan 1s. Kind of got like that holographic bubble like on the 13s. It's just not holographic. It's just that bubble. But that's what make these dope. You know what I'm saying? And I mean, if you got anything else, I know y'all know mostly about the Jordan 1. Talking about the Jordan 1 is really like talking about whatever. But we talking about this one. And like I said, I gave y'all my pros and cons to this one. And yeah, make sure y'all like, share, subscribe. Get us down there. Get us to 1,000 subscribers. We're giving our first giveaway away. If you've seen my last video, I'm telling y'all we're going to be giving away these kicks. I need y'all to definitely tap in. It's going to be a real giveaway. I don't know what you like. I don't know what you may like. I don't know how it is, but I got a bunch of sneakerheads in the city of in the state of Michigan, city of Detroit, whatever you want to put it. We all coming together, and we're going to dig in our closet, and, you know, if a grill is in my closet and you want it, there you go. If it's in that closet, we'll figure out how to get it. But don't worry about it. I'm definitely doing a giveaway if y'all get me to 1,000 subscribers. Also, check out my homie Sarah Appleby. Definitely a dope artist. I don't want to say her name wrong. I'll make sure I say her. She's definitely a dope artist. I'm trying to get her to do the intro for the channel. So, hey, y'all, do me a favor. Go tap her Instagram and tell her she need to make the intro and the outro for us again. You get what I'm saying? Let's turn it up and make a new one. I did kind of like my one that I used for the last video, and I'm going to use it for this video. But I will be changing it soon. I really didn't feel it. I think it could be better. And that's been another one. I am your boy, Young D Marks, and we out. Peace.
Baby, the feet playing smart out in these streets. Man. I gotta touch an M and get the fuck up out the D. I lost my brother a couple months ago. This shit ain't been the same. He got killed by some niggas we used to hang back in the day. When I catch you, boy, it's over. She can't hurt me, it can't hurt my soul. You won't catch me lacking, always keep my pole. Got a white bitch out of time, play with her nose. Oh,
I put the smoke in my lungs till I can't breathe. I put one in the air for the niggas that.